Ever since we are learning the subject of science, we came across one statement, that is, everything around us is made up of matter. And as we all know, this matter consists of atoms. These atoms belong to different elements. The smallest objects around us, from the smallest objects around us to the largest objects such as stars, galaxies, etc., etc., all these things are made up of matter, and this matter consists of atoms. Further going in detail, we also know that this atom also consists of other tiny particles such as electrons, protons, and neutrons. In 1803, there was one scientist known as John Dalton. He has proposed his theory, and his theory was later on known as Dalton's atomic theory. According to his theory, matter consists of atoms, and all the atoms of a given element are identical in nature. Later on, in 1897, there was one another scientist known as Sir J.J. Thomson. He has carried out one experiment which was known as cathode ray experiment. In this experiment, he concluded that atom consists of electrons, protons, and neutrons. Out of these three elements, these three constituent parts of atom, protons and neutrons are present at the nucleus, that is at the center, and electrons are revolving around that nucleus in their respective orbits. So this is historical background for our topic, that is measurement of matter. We have started this topic by defining matter, and we have defined matter as matter is anything that occupies space and has a mass, and this matter is made up of atoms. As we all know, when two or more atoms of same element, when they combine with each other, they form molecule. That is, molecule can be anything. It is made up of atoms of same element, or it can be made up of atoms of different elements. Generally, we classify molecules into two types, that is, homonuclear molecules or heteronuclear molecules. The examples of homonuclear molecules are O2. As you can see on the board, O2, it is an oxygen molecule, and this molecule is made up of two atoms of oxygen. Similarly, we have one another type of molecule, that is heteronuclear molecule, and the example of heteronuclear molecule is H2O. As we can see, H2O is a combination of two atoms of hydrogen along with one atom of oxygen. So these are the types of molecules, and we have defined molecule as they are the combinations of atoms, and these atoms may belong to same element or they may belong to different elements also. We have seen matter, we have seen molecules. Now we are going to see what are the compounds. As we all know, compounds are formed by chemical combination of different elements. For example, if we see the example of NaCl, in NaCl there is one atom of sodium and one atom of chlorine. When one atom of sodium reacts with one atom of chlorine, then it forms a compound called as NaCl. We call it as a common salt. As we can see, there is one major difference between molecules and compounds, that in compounds, compulsorily the atoms which are involved in the chemical reaction belong to different elements. But in case of molecule, it was not that case. For a molecule, it can be a homonuclear molecule or it can be a heteronuclear molecule. So these are the examples of compounds. After NaCl, we can have H2O as one another example of a compound, and so on. We can see we are going to see atomic mass. As we all know, atomic mass is a mass of an atom which is generally concentrated at its nucleus, and this atomic mass of an atom is generally represented by the sum of number of protons as well as neutrons which are already present at the nucleus of that atom. For example, if we consider an atom of oxygen, as we all know, an atom of oxygen has 8 electrons, and along with these 8 electrons we have 8 neutrons also. So the atomic mass of single atom of oxygen will be 16. So your atomic mass is nothing but it is the sum of number of protons and neutrons which are already present in the nucleus of an atom. Next, we are going to see the first and very important point of this chapter, that is law of chemical combination. As we have seen, during a chemical reaction, different elements combine with each other to form a product, and this product may have different chemical properties other than the reactants. That means when two atoms of different element combine with each other and they form a product, the chemical properties of the product can be different as compared to the reactants. This is all about the chemical nature of those reactants and those products. But if we think about their measurement or quantity, then we have to deal with some laws, and these laws are called as laws of chemical combination. In these laws of chemical combination, we essentially talk about the amount of reactants and the amount of product which are actually involved in that chemical reaction. That means when two different elements react with each other, we should have familiar with their masses. We must know their masses.